this organization, but also working with other organizations that might have different people in those positions.
You had mentioned your salary and the comparisons. Is that something, we can talk openly about that salary?
Sure.
So, kind of something I was thinking about is, as you mentioned Alliance, you mentioned gearing, but I kind of like to see it from a state level, like maybe North Platte, and kind of a cross comparison. And then I kind of like to see what the national average is for a city our size. So we're not like, oh, we just say, oh, you want more money? We're just gonna give it to you. I kind of want to see some numbers for me to feel comfortable moving along. But
I can give you some of those numbers that I have tonight.
Oh, okay.
The national average for a population 10,000 to 24,999, $132,100. Gearing's at 121,000. Alliance is at 120,000. Broken Bow is at 130,000. Sydney's at 113,000. Beatrice 140,420. North Fork's at 126,168. Columbus 150, York 113, Papillion 134, Grand Island 173,638, Crete 119,379, and I still have others out there. And my current salary is at 103, so. And I can send this to you all if you would like it as well.
That would be fine, because I'm sure I missed some of these as I was writing them down. But do you see us working on this as we go into our budget year? Because your contract should follow the budget year anyway.
We can work on that, but you know, outside of me, say if I were to get hit by a bus tomorrow, in looking at making sure that the city runs smoothly and efficiently, I would want that you pay that position adequate to what some of the other comparables are across the state. When you see communities that are, you know, half the size of us or even more that are paying a huge difference, $20,000 to $30,000, I want to make sure that you all can recruit somebody to fill this position. Well, hopefully that never happens.
I've seen the bus stop, so that's very possible.
I will say it is an honor and a privilege to work for the city of Scottsbluff. I enjoy working with you all and our staff. I don't have any intentions of leaving, but I want you all to be aware of what the trends are throughout the state as we move forward.
Would you be okay with getting these back out to council and then bringing your goals and objectives to the next meeting?
Sure.
And then we can put this back on an agenda item to kind of review that a little bit more.
Sure.
And are you willing, in putting your goals and objectives together, are you willing to work on any of the things from the ICMA that were average to enhance those in your goals to, you know, to accelerate the city in this next year?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you're willing to do that, then I would make a motion to give you a positive letter of confidence, a vote of confidence going in to lead the city into this next year, and we'll look at your goals and look at your wage structure for next at the next meeting.
Question on those salaries then?
Sure.
So, performance-based salaries are just, you know, this is what the average is, so if you want me to come work for you, this is what I'm going to charge you.
Well, that's base salaries.
Base salaries.
Yeah. And if you want, I can try to get copies of those agreements. It should be public record.
Some of the ones back east, I'd like to see some of their years of experience, because some of the ones that you've mentioned here, you know, I just want to know, see what a 1 to 5 year, 5 to 10 year years of experience are.
Mm-hmm.
And if they get something for longevity.
Sure.
Scott said if any of the cities were close to the same population, he would like to see those agreements.
Correct.
Yeah.
I know last year when we did your salary, we said it was going to be a, you know, we were starting there and we were planning on going up this time. So I mean, that, I don't think that's ever been a question, but I want to know we're going the right direction and we have solid information when we go forward. The whole take 5 cities and take the middle and that's where you get your weight. All that does is force everybody to go up forever. It, I mean, that's not realistic in the real world. It's a government thing. So I want to know how they're figuring their wages, basically, not just take 5 and look in the middle.
I think if Nathan can bring us
right,
back
and so I'm thinking that information will help.
Yep, I think it will too.
With the years of experience and the similar size agreements, I think that would be very beneficial.
Mm-hmm. Well, probably in the case of Alliance, you know, there was a manager there that already had some experience and had a
couple
what
years.
He was getting paid here. Some of those had just gotten there 3 years of service at that level.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to think that Lane over there in Gearing didn't get, maybe he got hired at that wage, maybe he slowly got there over a period of time.
That,
you know.
Yeah, and that was my point of
mm-hmm.
wanting to see it.
See those agreements and longevity.
Because some people make it for longevity instead of performance or both, so.
We I don't think any of us think that you are being paid what you need to be paid. I don't think that's the problem. I think we had talked last year that we were planning on doing a bump this year, pretty significantly. But we want to find out where it's at. So,
sure. Mm-hmm. That's fair.
Okay. So based on those items coming back to us and looking at your goals, leading us through the 2018-19. There's a motion on the table to give you a vote of confidence in leaving the city over the next year. I'm looking for a second.
Second.
Call the roll.
Shaver?
Yes.
Gonzalez?
Yes.
Cowell?
Yes.
Meininger?
Yes. Okay, 14. The purpose of this agenda item is to allow for public comment of items of potential discussion in future council meetings. Comments brought to the council for information only. Council will not take any action on the items except to refer it to staff or place on a different council agenda. Be limited to 3 minutes per person. Is anybody in the audience under public comment?
Okay, 3 minutes real quick. I just wanted to remind everyone or tell everyone again that Crestwell has been approved for an opportunity zone.
Mm-hmm.
The census tract that we submitted for was 144 Crestwell Street, the only one west of 1 Platte.
Wow.
So
that doesn't surprise me, honestly.
We look at continuing to grow the East Overland Corridor and Highway 26 coming into Crestwell. Also, PAD didn't get the Rural Workforce Housing Fund grant submitted. They did apply for funds through NYFA and got the full amount that was available, $250,000. There was a couple other communities as well as some local banks that put in for that fund. So Scott's Bluff's portion of that was $580,000.
Oh, great.
So.
Good deal. Good job. Okay, council reports. Senior Center is still adjusting to the bus routes and all that, but it's starting to smooth out. And tomorrow is the 911 task force. We'll be looking at approving the next funds for the CAD records management system. Youth Council, anything?
Prom was this weekend. Graduation's in 3 weeks. I know a few people are counting it down.
You being one?
I would be one of them.
Yeah.
But pretty much there's not a lot of sane information coming out of the high school right now. When you talk to people, they're all scatterbrained going everywhere. So spring fever's hit, and then graduation fever's hit on top of that. So it's pretty crazy there right now.
Okay. Good, we missed the snow.
Mm-hmm.
All right, seeing no other items come for the council, look for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Call the roll.
Gonzalez?
Yes.
Cowell?
Yes.
Meininger?
Yes.
Shaver?
Yes.
There you go.
go, Ken.
I'll be getting ideas and
there you go, Nathan. Try to script it.
Hey, Raymond.
You stop and see how it's white or it's
Broken.
Like glaring and